appreciate those nights and those dreams. But my friend, I'd sacrifice all those nights if I could make the earth and my dreams the same. The only difference is to let love replace all our hate. So let's go there, let's make our escape. Thank you.
Thank you. distinguished guest. Thank you for honoring Daryl with your presence this day. Thank you, and we bless you. Our purpose and our goal in this service today is first to give honor where honor is due. This is about Officer Daryl Pearson. This is about a husband, a father, a son. Also to celebrate a life that was well lived. And of course to remember our reason for hope in the face of such a tragedy, along with the connecting with the steps of healing and hope that each of us needs. In short, expect to mourn, expect to weep, expect to celebrate, and also expect to begin to heal by God's grace. In just a moment, some very close and special people will be telling us of what Daryl Pearson meant in their lives, the impression that he left upon their lives. But before they do, if I may, I'd like to suggest just a thought. It's been said that the fingerprints of God are all over his creation, especially upon mankind.
That is the most important thing. Daryl Pearson's life and how he lived it is an example to every single one of us. It is about family, it is about faith, it is about service. And because of what happened last week, his family will never be the same. They will not enjoy the things that many of us will enjoy with our children, our families. We have to remember and pay tribute to him, remember what he did. That, to me, that epitomizes everything. So in closing, I just like to close by saying, to Amy and Pearson and Devin's family, I'm going to say God bless you. I'm so sorry for what you're going through. You move in our thoughts and prayers. So every police officer here, I would like also to say God bless each and every one of you. And I will pray, we should all pray for one thing, that every police officer in this room, around this state, around this country, has the opportunity that Daryl Pearson did not have after last week to serve your communities and be able to go home at night and spend time with your family. We pray to God you stay safe for the rest of your careers. And you don't ever have to go through what the Pearson family is going through today and what these police officers are going through today as well. Thank you and God bless you.
Check his gear, if they break his eye, he gives his loved ones a lie. In the simple performance of duty, he reported for work, drove with his buddies at roll call, and made his last trip down the squad from the hall. In the simple performance of duty, he answered the call, to help the helpless, to find the lost, no matter the danger or how great the cost. In a simple performance of duty, he laid down his life for those in peril he tried to save a brave friend. It was great. In simple forms of duty, he honored his need. And as we carry him to rest, and the flag draped on his casket, long after the world has died, we shall never forget. Never judge or regret what he did in the simple forms of duty. Leave here tonight. Go home. And hug your husbands, wives, the kids, and tell them what you love. To Amy, Brian, Mrs. Pearson. I'm so sorry. Like the lieutenant said, we have gained. Check his gear with a brick his eye. He kisses his loved ones goodbye. In the simple performance of duty, he reported for work, drove with his buddies at roll call, and made his last trip down the squad on the wall. In the simple performance of duty, he answered the call. The helpless, to find the lost, no matter the danger or how great the cost. In a simple performance of duty, he laid down his life for those in peril he tried to save. A brave friend. It was great. In a simple performance of duty, he honored his need. And as we carry him to rest, and the flag draped on his casket, long after the world has died, we shall never forget. Never judge or regret what he did in the simple forms of duty. Leave here tonight. Go home. And hug your husbands, wives, the kids, and tell them what you love. To Amy, Brian, Mrs. Pearson. I'm so sorry. Like the lieutenant said, we have gained.
Good afternoon, Father Don Wolfschlager. Along with the clergy response team, thanks to Chief Duffy for asking me to go to the airport. But as he's running, he locks the car. 20 minutes later, frozen stiff, I'm standing there, and he says, what are you doing out of the car? I says, you locked the car. He says, why didn't you call me? I said, my phone's in the car. The only thing that gave me any comfort was to stand against that engine and just get the heat off of there. He just looked at me with that little smile he had and said, sorry, Father. One day, God forgive me, I swore. Daryl turns to me and he looks at me and he gives me this smile, turns back and he just keeps going, doesn't say anything. Daryl was quiet. He was a quiet man of faith. We didn't talk much about God or the church, but I saw his love for God in the way he worked, in the way he talked of his family, of Christian, of Amen. And I haven't gotten the privilege to be chaired, but I know that she was the apple of his eye. He possessed a code of personal integrity. Honor guided him to do the right thing always, even when no one was looking. It was not only his duty, but also a distinction. Daryl possessed honor, and I held him and do hold him in honor. It was found in his beliefs, but it was exhibited through his actions as he dealt with everyday things on the job. He lived up to the highest standards, ethically and morally. When his principles were tested, it's courage that prevented him from getting angry or going berserk or even just getting upset if it was a sad case that we were in.
Thank you to everybody. I was afraid that I would come up here and this would be the time when the emotions would catch up with me. But Richie cried enough for both of us, so. Thank you for that, Richie. Now to my official speech. I struggled to decide what was appropriate to say in this setting. Today is all about Daryl, celebrating who he is and honoring his accomplishments. The press has given me the opportunity to speak about the kind of man that he is, and I appreciate that. Protecting and serving was a way of life for Daryl. He did it because he believed in this city. I have kept a scrapbook of his accomplishments, and he would come home with chief's letters of recognition and not even tell me. I would find them on the counter because that's the kind of officer he was. He did it for the community and not for recognition. But he was able to be home with us until 2 days before his death. So we got 8 months of family time together. And our last weekend together, Labor Day, was spent in the mountains as a family. So those were precious memories that we'll always have. We'll never understand why God allows these things to happen. He's given us free will. And as I think Lieutenant Paul said, some people like Thomas Johnson III have taken that freedom and used it in the worst possible way. I've been asked how I feel about him, and when the time's appropriate, I will speak up. I'll be at every hearing. I'll be at his inevitable sentencing, and I will be there to remind him who I am and to let him know that he does not have power over me.
Yes, they're straight from their mother. Why all these humans?